spill the theories, here to spill some theories. So guys, are you ready for yet another theory spill? I sure am. Quick reminder that this video contains spoilers. If you haven't played any of the Little Nightmares games, I suggest you look away. You have been warned. Also, these gameplays aren't mine. All rightful owners have been linked down below. All right, let's get started. I'm sure you've read the title of this video. Why does Mono wear a paper bag? Before we talk about Mono's disguise, we need to talk about something else first. People covering their faces in Little Nightmares is pretty normal. Most of the characters have their faces covered. The most popular example are the chefs, since we can actually see them scratch their real faces under their masks. Other examples are the janitor, the guest, the lady, and most importantly, Mono. There's no real explanation as to why characters decide to cover their faces. As of now, the fandom has come up with a few possibilities, such as to hide their identity, or some even believe that the masks are made out of dead people's skins to blend in better with the crowds. Something else we discover in Little Nightmares 2 is that the doctor is the one behind the mask. In the hospital chapter, there's a room with masks hang up on the wall and on shelves, hinting that he is the one who makes them and probably ships them to the law. Who is Mono? If you have played Little Nightmares, I'm sure you know who Mono is. Mono is the main protagonist of Little Nightmares 2 and the character we play as during the whole duration of the game. He wears a trench coat with a key holder. He isn't much taller than other children we've seen in Little Nightmares, and of course, he wears a paper bag. On another note, the prefix Mono means one, only, or singular. In summary, it means that Mono is always alone, which is actually true since he starts off alone, gets separated from Six a few times, and ends up alone, and all of this over and over again. Let's read Mono's few character descriptions. Let's start off with Twitter. An uncommonly single-minded child. When he sets himself to a task, he rarely gives up before it's completed. To me, this tells us about the time loop theory. Tin Man's goal is to save Mono from continuing the time loop. He tries to save Mono by taking away Six, hinting at the quote, "He rarely gives up before it's completed." Let's now go to the website's description. As the world buckles under the relentless pulse of the signal tower, Mono takes refuge where he can. His thin paper mask offers some respite, helping him forget that the outside world hates him and wants him to fail. But he can't stay hidden forever. For this one, it hints to us that Mono is secretly Tin Man. Personally, I think that the outside world hates Tin Man, aka Mono, because he's the one keeping the signal tower alive. They want Mono to fail because it's gonna save the world. While playing, I'm sure a lot of us realize that Six seems invisible. No monster in Little Nightmares 2 chases after Six. When they see Six, they do nothing. But when they see Mono, they go ballistic and chase after him, possibly trying to stop him from achieving his journey to the tower, perhaps. It's also possible that they quite literally just hate him and would like to get rid of him in any way, shape, or form. Let's get to the juicy part of this video. I believe Mono wears a paper bag because the signal tower wants to hide his identity. Let me elaborate. Like I stated, the signal tower needs a host in order to survive. And as we know, Mono is and always will become that host. And the signal tower knows that. And of course it would know, it is the one behind the time loop. In the beginning of Little Nightmares 2, Mono wakes up close to a TV, telling us he just came out of that same TV. Ever wonder how he ended up there? He ends up there because the time loop is restarting. After we watch Tin Man getting locked into the room, another young Mono appears from somewhere. That young Mono is the one we play as. The signal tower deliberately put a paper bag over his face in order for him to stay hidden so nobody would recognize him and stop him from journeying to the tower and then become Tin Man again. There's one itsy bitsy thing that bothers me though. In the first Little Nightmares digital comic, we can see the history of how Six ends up in the hunter's cabin. While Six is running away, she sees Mono for the first time sitting on a tree branch alone. This, however, does not match with the beginning of Little Nightmares 2 because we just casually walk to the hunter's cabin without ever climbing on any kind of tree. So, I made up something that could make sense. The few seconds of encountering that we see Six and Mono were in another time loop, not the one we are experiencing while playing. But what do you think? Once again, this is purely based on what I believe and what I researched. You always have room to decide what you believe is true and what isn't. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe and comment on some of your theories. Take care, and I will see you guys soon for more theory spills.